This screencast will go over how to perform a reverse Google search, which is something you might need to do if you come across a paywall on an article when you are searching on the internet. My example for today, I have searched Arizona voting rights Supreme Court, and I have found an LA Times article here. And typically with LA Times, you will get one or two free viewings of articles per month, and then you are required to subscribe and you have to pay. So normally there will be a paywall that pops up here. This is actually the first article of the month I'm viewing, so I'm not quite getting that yet, other than the note to subscribe. But if I were to read a couple more articles, I would start running to that paywall. And so there's a trick you can do to get access to articles when you do have a paywall, and that is to look for them in the Cuesta Library databases. And I will show you how to do that now. So you can access the library from your My Cuesta portal. And this is where you'll land, and you'll just need to scroll down here to the services section. And I have actually already starred the library, so it's in my quick favorites tab right here. So when you get to the library homepage, you'll go to the database A through Z list. And then you can actually search by database type. So we're going to select to search by newspaper articles. And once you get here, you'll see we do have 8 databases that have newspapers in them. And it does take some time to get familiar with what specifically is in each, but I do know that the LA Times is available in the US Newsstream database, and you can see it. It does list that here as well. So I'm going to go right ahead to the US Newsstream database. And at this point, there are a couple of things you can do to search. You can use keywords from the article title, or you can search for the title itself. And that is actually what I'm going to do right now. So I've already copied the title of that article, and I put it in these quotation marks because I want it to search for the title as a phrase rather than retrieve all of these articles that aren't quite as relevant. So this will hopefully pinpoint me to the exact article I need. And it looks like it did do that. So that's great. If I did use just keywords here, a couple of these keywords, I would probably have to filter over here on the left-hand side, such as by full text and maybe even by date to narrow my results. But since we searched for the title, it brought us right to the article. And I'm going to right away just click full text here because that's what I want to access. And once you do click the full text, you will be sent to the items record and you'll be able to read the full article, and you completely skip over that paywall, which is really nice. A couple of things that are helpful from this specific database: you can save this article as a PDF to your desktop. You can also cite this article by clicking the automatic citation generator. You can select the type of citation style that your instructor has asked you to cite in. And then always, always double check that the citation is correct, because sometimes they tend to be off just slightly. So always double check that the citation is correct. And then you can copy it there and put it into your document. And another thing that can be helpful is this little details tab here next to the full text. This can actually give you some great keywords for a topic and also provides a little additional information about the article itself, such as who is the author, the publication year, and some more specific details. So that is how you perform a reverse Google search. If you have any questions, please contact us at the library. I will show you where you can find the librarian information. So I'm back on the library homepage. And if you ever need to speak with us, you can click this Ask a Librarian feature. Thank you so much for viewing.